Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I know I haven't been posting any videos. I was just so busy this past month. I didn't have time for anything at all. But I do have some couple of videos that I'm ready to post sometimes this week. But right now, I just want to do a monthly favorites video because it's already May. And let's just get started. First thing I want to talk about today, it's a daily cream and it's by a company called Innisfree. And it's a green tea seed cream enriched with fresh green tea seeds and squeezed green tea from the pure green tea. It delivers abundant moisture and nourishment deep into your skin. I love this cream. It smells like green tea. The smell is just so good. It's not oily. It's very moisturizing, very nourishing. Lately I've been having a very dry skin. I don't know what it is. I guess it's the weather. Very dry weather. I don't know. This cream is actually really nourishing and moisturizing. So the next item, it's also by a Korean brand Innisfree, and it's a BB cream. I know I've talked before about BB creams and that I use only BB creams, but this BB cream is a long wear BB cream with SPF 30. The color that I got is a little too light for me. I still can go with it if I just powder it. It doesn't have a good coverage. I would say it's medium coverage BB cream. I don't need a heavy coverage, but I prefer a little more heavier than this BB cream provides. And it is a long wear BB cream. It's very thick. So I can put it on my skin. I know you won't be able to see this cream, it's right here. It's very thick consistency, very thick consistency. So a little bit goes a long way, and you can tell that it's a way too bright for me. I like that it feels like a cream, because other BB creams that I have, they feel more like a liquid foundation than a cream. This feels like a cream, so I like this. Probably if I will repurchase this BB cream again, it will be just in a different shade. And the next product that I want to talk about is a powder foundation, and the powder foundation, and it's by Urban Decay. It's their Naked Skin Ultra Powder Foundation. Let me open this so you guys can see. The color that I'm wearing, it's light warm. I think they also have light beige. It's very, very soft and fine. I love this foundation. It's very soft when you touch it. It almost feels like a cream foundation. You can use it also wet. I haven't tried that yet, but it's very, very soft. If you touch it, it's very smooth. It's very soft, very silky. It's just overall, it's just very, very good powder foundation. This sponge applicator, it looks more cakey because I think the sponge applicator gives me more product, but it leaves me a little cakey. So instead of that, I prefer to use a powder brush, and that's the next item that I want to talk about. And this powder brush that I'm using with my powder foundation is by Sonia Kashuk. I think this came in a kit. It's a brush kit. I don't remember right now what's the name of that kit, but I like this brush very much. It's very soft, very, very soft. You can barely feel it when you put it on your skin. So I like to use my foundation with this brush. It doesn't leave me cakey. Gives me just perfect amount of coverage and perfect amount of product on my face. I love it. It just feels like feathers. Feels like feathers on my skin. I love it. It's very nice. Very good quality. Doesn't have no number. The only thing is gets dirty very quick because it's white, but I like it anyway. So the next product that I want to talk about is a blush. And this blush, I'm not sure if I mentioned before, but it's by Milani Luminoso Baked Powder Blush. It's a peachy color. orangey peachy color. Full, very beautiful color. I don't know if you can see. I know it doesn't make. It's very sheer color. Very, very pretty color on your face. I think it goes well with any skin tone. I think overall I've been satisfied with Milani's blushes. I love all their colors. For this month, this is my favorite. So the next three items that I want to talk about, three products that I want to talk about are lipstick products, and one is by NYX. And this item and this product I have for a while now. I just rediscovered again, and I am wearing it on my lips right now. And it's one of NYX Soft Matte Lip Creams. And this is in color Istanbul. It's a pink matte color. And this is, let me see, let me make a swatch and show you how it looks. I don't know if you can tell. But it's very pigmented color. It's matte color, but it's not drying lipstick. It's very moisturizing lipstick. It feels like a butter, and I think that's what it's called. It's a lip cream. It feels like you have a cream on your lips, but it's matte. It's not shiny. It's just plain matte color, but it leaves my lips very soft. Leaves my lips very soft. I love this, and the color is very pretty. For me, it looks more natural and pinky, but I love the matte finish. It's just very, very beautiful color. The next lipstick I want to talk about is by Maybelline, and I'm not sure if I mentioned this lipsticks in or lip glosses in any of my other videos. I probably one of my tutorials, but this one is by Maybelline. Those two colors, and I love these lipsticks or lip glosses. They're very, very rich. Very moisturizing and very buttery, very shiny. And the two colors that I have is one is by Breathtaking Apricot, and this is orange peachy apricot color basically. And the second one is Hibiscus Heaven. It's a pink color. And let me make swatches for you. I like the lip glosses because the applicator is very nice. They're very pigmented, you can tell, very pigmented. This one is apricot, very glossy, and this one is hibiscus, and you can see, this is just one swatch. Very pigmented, very glossy, they look amazing on your lips, and they're very moisturizing. They're not sticky at all, like some lipsticks can, lip glosses can be very sticky. I don't like lip glosses that are sticky, that's why I don't buy too many lip glosses. Alright, moving on. My last thing that I want to talk about is actually not a skincare, not a makeup item. It's actually an item for your phone. And I know it's getting popular. I bought mine online, and you can buy them, I think, in any store, even I think in any cell phone accessory stores, or in the mall or anywhere. It's a very inexpensive item, but I've got my item online, very inexpensive. And it's a selfie stick. Sometimes when I go out in public with this thing, people look at me like, what is she doing? But I like this. I like this selfie stick because I don't need anyone taking my pictures. It looks very unique. Sometimes I don't feel like asking people, can you please take a picture of me? Sometimes I feel like it's very inconvenient or uncomfortable asking people to take a picture of you. Sometimes I just want to take a picture, just a selfie of myself, and even in my room or whatever, whenever, and without people asking anyone to take a picture of myself. And this is very convenient, and it's very small. This part comes out and it fits in your purse, and it's very lightweight, and anytime you're somewhere with your friends or anywhere, you just take a picture and it fits to your phone or point and shoot cameras, like small point and shoot cameras. It's very, very, I like it. It's very long, super long, and it won't fit in the camera, but it's very long. a very convenient item. I also have a Bluetooth control for the phone, so whenever I have to snap a picture, I don't have to put on a timer or extend my hand, you know, that works with any phone, Android or iPhone, and I just press the button while holding the selfie stick, and very, very convenient. It came with the selfie stick. I purchased mine online. You can buy it on Amazon, eBay, anywhere. I actually have another monopod, but it's more heavy duty, and that one I use for my DSLR camera. So yeah, this is my last item that I want to talk about, and I just want to thank everyone for watching my videos. Please don't forget to thumbs up or like my videos down below, and don't forget to subscribe. There's a new vlog coming this week. I'm gonna upload it sometime either today or sometime this week. It's a vlog from my vacation, and hopefully if you guys like my vlog videos, I will continue doing either weekly vlogs or monthly vlogs. Just let me know if you want to see vlogs, if you're interested in vlogs. Leave me a comment down below. And that's it. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.